Hello, hello, and welcome to this new series called Polynomial Academy, where we will discuss everything that a trader needs to know about the world of crypto trading and decentralized finance. We will discuss themes from the alleys of traditional finance, like trading indicators and risk management, but also DeFi concepts like liquidity pools and funding rates. Now, coming to the topic for this particular video, decentralized crypto perpetual futures contracts. Literally everything in there is a jargon in itself. But don't worry, we will make it easier for you to understand through help of examples. But you know what's already pretty easy? Subscribing to the channel and hitting a like button. It's literally zero effort, guys. So do that right away without any delay. And let's get started. Before we bring in the decentralization angle, let's understand what are perpetual contracts and how do they differ from their older cousin, futures contract. A futures contract is a derivative instrument which derives its value from an underlying asset like stocks, fiat currencies, and even crypto assets. It also allows traders to take leverage and open a position which is bigger than their trading capital, thus magnifying the potential profits and losses from the trade. The way these contracts work is that there is a pre-decided price for buying and selling of the underlying asset at a pre-decided future date, which is called expiration or settlement date. However, most futures contracts are actually cash settled and don't practically involve the buying and selling of the actual asset. The loss-making party simply pays the other one on the settlement date, depending on the price movements in the underlying asset. Perpetual contracts work exactly like futures, except that they don't have a settlement date. Instead of settlement, perpetual contracts have a fee called the funding rate that is paid by one party to the other in order to keep the contract price aligned with the underlying asset's spot price. This fee is calculated and paid at regular intervals, typically every 8 hours, based on the difference between the futures price and the spot price. If the futures price is higher than the spot price, the funding rate is positive, and traders with long positions need to pay a funding fee to those with short positions, thus incentivizing more traders to short the markets and bring down the futures price till it is at par with the spot price. Similarly, when the futures price is lower than the spot price, the funding rate is negative, and short traders need to pay a funding fee to the long traders, which incentivizes more and more long positions in the market and brings up the futures price to the levels of the spot price. Since perpetual contracts don't have a settlement, the traders can theoretically hold the position indefinitely and take advantage of the price movements in the underlying asset without the pressure of a deadline. By the way, we've also made a detailed video on how you can use the funding rates for arbitrage trading, which can be found up here, and the link is also in the description. Finally, let's figure out how the decentralized perps work differently from the ones listed on centralized exchanges. The critical difference revolves around obtaining updated contract prices and the way the orders are executed. Centralized perps mostly use order book mechanism for executing orders and get pricing feed directly from the exchange servers. On the other hand, decentralized perps are built on top of layer 1 or layer 2 blockchains and use smart contracts for order execution. Using smart contracts enables newer methods of order matching, such as automated market making or AMM, beyond just the traditional order book mechanism. However, smart contracts are just self-executing pieces of code, which can't access real-time price feeds from the internet. This is where price oracles come into the picture. Oracles are systems that provide real-world off-chain data to a blockchain and make it usable for the smart contracts. Now, in case of Polynomial, our perps are built on the Synthetix protocol, where their SNX staking pool acts as a temporary counterparty to the trades executed through our AMM smart contract, and off-chain oracles from Pith Network and Chainlink provide up-to-date price data. The combination of AMM execution and price oracles provide seamless centralized perp-like experience for traders while always keeping custody of their assets. So that's it for this video. I hope you have a better understanding of perpetual contracts and their decentralized version now. But there's just one aspect of all the crypto and DeFi knowledge you need to become a pro trader. We're building this Polynomial Academy series to ensure that you understand all other concepts really well. So subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to avoid missing out on other useful videos. I'll see you in the next one.